this video, we learn about AND function and OR function. We have a table with some cars, and each car has many options, like type, cylindrical capacity, fuel, color, and price. And we want to sell these cars to some customers. We have customer 1 and customer 2. Customer 1 wants a car with two options: price less than 15,000 and type C. For this, we'll use an if function with an AND function within our formula. Customer 2 wants or a diesel car or a cylindrical capacity greater than 1.6. And for this, we're gonna use OR function. So, customer 1 will use AND function, and for customer 2 we'll use OR function, both of them within our IF function. We start with customer 1 and write equal if. Press tab to open the brackets, and then we must write the first argument of our if function. As we said, customer 1 wants a car with two options: price to be less than 15,000 and type to be C. For this, we're gonna write both options in our first argument from if formula. So, and, press tab, and now we're gonna write the options. E2, meaning the price to be less than 15,000, and A2, meaning car type to be equal with C. Then we close the brackets and write the second argument of our if function. As you already know, if function contains three arguments. First one, the expression with the logical test that we already wrote, and then the second argument and the third argument are linked to the true or false of our expression. So the second argument will be yes if our options are fulfilled, and the third argument will be no if at least one of our arguments of our options from the first argument are not fulfilled. If we copy the formula, we'll see that for customer 1 we have only one option, because, for example, even if this car is type C, one of our options wasn't fulfilled, because the price is greater than 15,000. Now we're gonna start writing the formula for customer 2, who wants or a car that is with diesel fuel, or a car with a cylindrical capacity greater than 1.6. And for this, we'll use the same if function combined with OR function. Open the brackets, select our options, and these are cylindrical capacity greater than 1.6, so B2 greater than 1.6, or the fuel diesel. So C2 equal diesel. So now we close the brackets, write the second argument of our if formula. Like we did on the first customer, we have yes, and in this case we're gonna obtain yes if at least one of our options will be true. And the third argument will be no, only if none of our options is true. So now, as you see, we have many options for our customer 2, because we have here diesel, here we have diesel and also greater than 1.6, and here we have 1.6, which it's not true, but we have diesel, which is true. So these are our options for our customers.